The World Wide Web is nothing but communication between web clients and web servers. Clients are mobile, laptop, computer, or any such communication device, normally using browsers like Chrome, Internet Explorer, Safari, or any such program. For communications, clients have to follow a set of rules or procedures for transmitting the data, known as protocol. HTTP stands for Hypertext Transfer Protocol. HTTP is used for such communication in which a client sends an HTTP request to the web. A web server that often computers providing resources and data to client over the network receives the client request. The server runs an application to process the request. Then server returns response to the client. The client receives the response and render it in a browser, and you can see your requested web page. So in this video we will learn how HTTP protocol works, so watch it till the end. When you visit a page on the web, your computer uses the Hypertext Transfer Protocol, HTTP, to download the page from server using internet. HTTP is an application level TCP/IP based communication protocol that is used to transfer data like HTML files, images, query results, etc. on the World Wide Web. HTTP specifies how clients' request data will be considered and sent to the server, and how the servers respond to these requests in response. When we want to browse the web, we can use phone, laptops, desktops with browser application installed. When user type a uniform resource locator URL in the browser, like HTTP protocol for the fetch the document with //, and since we are opening the websites of suppose LD College of Engineering, so we will write ldce.ac.in and press enter. Here you can see it is easy to remember and type nice human friendly URLs in the browsers like ldce.ac.in, wikipedia.org, or google.com. But as we know, in the computer networks, each device identified by IP address. So to get the IP address, the browser uses a DNS resolver to map the domain to an IP address. DNS resolver now gives you IP address for our requested website like ldce.ac.in. Once the browser gets the IP address of the server computer hosting the requested URL, it sends the HTTP request. In the first line of HTTP request, we have a text like this. The first word is the HTTP method, like GET. The GET method is used to retrieve information from the server. You can use other methods like POST, which is used to send data to the server. For example, customer information file upload using HTML forms. The HEAD method asks for response identical to that of GET request, but without the response body. PUT method replaces the target resource. DELETE method deletes the specified resource. The CONNECT method is used by the client to establish a network connection to a web server over HTTP. The options describe the communications options for the target resource, while TRACE method performs a message loopback test along the path to the target resource, which is used for debugging purpose at the time of development. Next, slash indicate the path of resource. Here it is server root, but if you access contact page, it would be like slash contact. After that, it shows the protocol and its version. Here it is HTTP protocol with versions 1.1. Other things in the header is the host, which specifies the domain name and port number of the server to which the request is being sent. Here host is ldce.ac.in and HTTP will use default port 80 once it is not specified. Next information is for the key like connection, which have a value like keep alive, indicate the connection is persistent and not closed. User agent identify the applications, and for most of the browsers it shows Mozilla, and operating system like Windows. Accept tells about the client is able to understand text like HTML, application like XHTML plus XML, and various image formats like JXR and many other formats. The accept encoding request HTTP header advertises which content encoding, usually a compression algorithm, the client is able to understand. Here it is like gzip and deflate. Accept language tells about which natural language client understands. In our example, client understand US English as a language. Now this entire request goes to server. Server understands the request and process using various server-side scripting languages like PHP, Java, ASP, etc. and sometimes get the data from databases and generate the page for you. Servers sends it back to client via HTTP response. HTTP response contain status line containing protocol with version number and status code. Status code 200 tells request is okay. Status code is 3-digit integer, where first digit of the status code defines the class of response. If it is 1, it shows status is informational. 2 is for success. 3 is for redirection. 4 says about client error, while 5 is for server error. the important status code like 100 continue. This status code tells about client should continue with the request, while 202 accepted tells the request is accepted for the processing, but the processing is not complete. 302 found tells the request page has moved temporarily to the new URL. 400 bad request says about server did not understand the request. 401 unauthorized says the requested page needs the username and password. 404 not found tells us the server cannot find the requested page, while status code like 500 tells us internal server error. After status line, we have different key value pairs in the HTTP response header, like cache control tells about the maximum amount of time a resource is considered fresh. Connection is persistent, so it shows keep alive. Server encoded the content with gzip compression techniques given in the content encoding. Content length tells about how many bytes are there in the response, while content type indicate content type written by the server along with the character set. In our example, it is text HTML. Date gives the date and time at which the message was originated, and expires shows the time till you can consider your resource is fresh. Here we have max age is equal to 1. So after 1 second our resource is considered expired. X clockwork ID contains the unique identifier for the HTTP request. X clockwork versions tells the version number, and X powered by tells about web application technology like PHP in the HTTP response. After this type of header information, there will be one empty line indicating end of the header section. After that, there will be a message body containing whole HTML for our web page in response. This entire response comes back to the client. At last, when browser get the response, it understand the response and renders it. And you can see nice web page of LD College of Engineering. If you want to see the header informations in your browser, you can open your browser like Internet Explorer and right click and open Inspect Element. You can see various tab here in which you can go to the Network tab and refresh the page. Click on the particular name or path and you can see all your request and response header along with all the values here. That's all about HTTP protocol. I hope you understand all the basics about HTTP protocol. Thanks and bye-bye. If you like this video, press like and subscribe the channel and share the video, and don't forget to press the bell icon for my new video notifications. Thanks for watching.